Good morning, students. This is my second video related with subject verb agreement. So in previous video, I taught you what is subject verb agreement, how it works in English language, and how to determine whether the subject of a sentence is singular or plural. So in this video, we will have a look on some more rules and exceptions. Okay. And I think if you learn all these rules nicely, you will be able to do the further four exercises A, B, C, D. So let's have a look on the rules and the exception related with subject verb agreement. Name of certain games, diseases, and branch of knowledge which ends in S are singular. For example, billiards, mathematics, measles, physics, politics, and mumps. Mumps is a serious illness. Mathematics is an important subject in modern world. Now in this both sentences we see that the subject mumps and mathematics, it carries S, means it ends in S, but the following verb is singular. Some plural noun when express a specific quantity and number become singular. For example, a 10 rupee note, a 3 months old baby. For example, a 10 rupee note was lying on the table. A 3 months old baby was crying bitterly. So in this two sentence we see that the subject of the sentence is expressing quantity and number. This is the reason that the following verb is singular. When two singular nouns are joined by and, always take plural verb. For example, Mohan and Rohan always come late. In the sentence, we see that here two nouns, Mohan and Rohan, are joined by and. So the following verb is in plural form. But if they represent one idea, they take singular verb. For example, slow and steady wins the race. Here, the two singular noun like slow and steady, they are also joined with the help of and, but they are representing and giving the singular idea. So, the following verb is wins. Okay, the following verb is also singular. If two singular noun refers to the same person or thing, the following verb must be singular. For example, the poet and philosopher is dead. Here, the subject, the poet and philosopher, is indicating towards one person. So, the following verb is, that is singular. If article the is used once, then two nouns refer to the same person. So, the verb will be singular. But if it's mentioned twice, then it refers to two persons. And the following verb should be plural. For example, the poet and the philosopher are dead. Here we see that the poet and the philosopher, because article the is used twice, it is referring to two different persons. So the following verb is also plural. If two singular nouns are joined by and are preceded by each or every, the following verb remains in singular form. For example, each day and each hour brings us fresh anxiety. Every man and every woman in the village was terrified. Here we see that in the first sentence, day and hour are singular nouns and are joined by and, but they are preceded by each, means the each comes first. So in such sentences, when each and every come first, the following verb should be in singular form. Two or more singular subjects when connected by or, nor, either or, neither nor. They always take singular verb. For example, either Mohan or Rohan has made this mistake. Neither he nor I was mistaken. Here we see that two subject in the first sentence, two subject, Mohan and Rohan, they are joined by, they are connected by either or, so the following verb has is singular. In the same way, neither he nor I, here despite the fact that there are two subject, he and I, but they are connected with neither nor, so the following verb should be singular, that is was. So you can bear in mind that if one of the nouns in is plural, then following verb will be plural. For example, John or his brothers are to be blamed. If the same sentence, we see that the first noun is singular but the second noun is plural, then the verb will be according to the second plural noun. If two nouns are joined by with or as well as, then the following verb agree with the first noun. For example, Rama as well as her friends has won the prize. Here we see that Rama and her friends, they are connected with as well as, so the following verb is singular despite the fact that the second verb second noun is friends, that is plural, but when we connect it with and as well as, then the following verb should be singular and only singular. So I hope you have understood all the rules of subject verb agreement and you will apply them while doing further exercises. So your homework will be exercise A, B and C, D. So let's do exercise E. This is the last exercise of this chapter. And in this exercise, you have to rectify the error of subject verb agreement. First, most of the money have been spent. So here we see that money is a singular noun, so the following verb will be has. Money is always considered singular because it indicates toward the riches. A lot of people in our village is poor. Here we see that people is a plural noun, so the following verb should be are. There are plenty of room in the back row. Here the room is indicating towards the space, okay, so it is a singular noun, so there will be, there is plenty of room in the back row, okay. There are a lot of money invested in the business in our country. Again, there is a lot of money because money is considered singular. One of my friends have a fine collection of postage stamps. We see that France is a plural noun, but when it is preceded by one of, then it becomes singular. So the answer will be, one of my friends has a fine collection of postage stamp. The United States have many fighter planes. Here the United States is a singular noun, so the following verb should also be singular and the answer is has. A group of people were standing at the street corner. Here we see that the people is a plural noun, but it is preceded by a group of, which makes it singular, and the answer will be was. One of the children were given a scholarship. Here again, children is a plural noun, but it is preceded by one of the, so it becomes singular, and the following verb will be was. Half of the apples was rotten. When we use fraction like half, one third, one fourth, then the verb agrees with the noun, whether it is singular or plural. So here apple is a plural noun, so the following verb will be were. Not one of the mangoes were sour. Again, mangoes is a plural noun, but it is preceded by not one of the, which makes it singular, and the following verb should also be singular, that is, was.